This is going to be the second video about factoring a second-degree polynomial using the AC method. So here's the problem we're working with this time. I've got 16x squared plus 52x minus 14. Now, looking at these numbers, you say, oh, that's the AC method. But before you dive into it, take a look at the numbers and see if you can maybe simplify it somewhat by factoring out some common term. And since they're all even, we know we can factor out a 2. We can't factor out any x's because this 14 doesn't have an x at all. Okay, so let's factor out the 2. It'll make it a little easier. So factoring a 2 out of this polynomial, I'm going to get 2 times 8x squared plus, let's see, 2 into 52 is 26. So that's 26x. Let's fix that plus sign, okay? And 2 into negative 14 is negative 7. Okay, so this is a bit easier. The 8 is going to be my a, 26 is going to be my b, and negative 7 is going to be my c. So let's see what ac is. Well, ac is 8 times negative 7. That's going to give me a negative 56. Pay attention to the signs. And my b is a 26. So I want to find two factors of 56. One's going to be positive, one's going to be negative. And when I add them together, I'll get a 26. Okay, here we go. So 56 could be 1 times 56. The difference between 1 and 56 is 55. So that's not going to make it. 56 is even, so I could divide it by 2. So let's see, that would give me 2, and 2 into 56 is 28. And the difference between 2 and 28, oh, this is nice. The difference between 2 and 28 is 26. So it looks like I'm there already. Now I just have to decide, remember I said 1 is positive, 1 is negative. Well, I want a positive 26. So that would mean the bigger number would be positive. So it's going to be a negative 2 and a positive 28. Now I'll go back to my second degree polynomial, this part in parentheses, and I'm going to break down this middle term into these two numbers that I've got. Okay, so that's going to give me 2 times, I'm going to go to square brackets because I'm going to need them, 2 times 8x squared minus 2x. When you've got a choice, by the way, always start with the number that has the negative sign. Minus 2x plus 28x minus 7. And my square brackets again. Now the reason I use square brackets is because remember I want to group these and I'll use parentheses for them. And that way we can keep track of where the brackets and parentheses are. So four terms here, which means I'm going to factor this by grouping, put parentheses around the first two terms and around the second two terms. And now let's see what I can do. So I've still got my 2. Let's use the brackets again. 8x squared minus 2x. Okay, I can divide both these numbers by 2, and I can divide out an x. So dividing 8x squared by 2x is going to give me a 4x, and dividing negative 2x by 2x will just give me a negative 1. Going on to the second parentheses, set of parentheses, I've got 28x minus 7. I can divide out a 7. I can factor it out. So that's going to be 7. 28 divided by 7 is 4, so that's 4x. Negative 7 divided by 7 is negative 1. Close my brackets. And what do I have? I've got a 4x minus 1 and a 4x minus 1. Okay, so that means, let's not forget the 2. I'm going to factor out the 4x minus 1. And that's going to leave me with my other factor as 2x plus 7. And it looks like I don't need these brackets anymore, so I can take them away. I'm going to have 2 times 4x minus 1 times 2x plus 7. So this should be my answer. Let's multiply it all back just to make sure. So I'm going to have 2 times 4x times 2x is 8x squared. 4x times 7 is 28x. Negative 1 times 2x is negative 2x. And my last two numbers are negative 1 and 7, so that's negative 7. Combining the middle terms, I'll get 2 times 8x squared plus 26x minus 7. Then I want to multiply, I want to distribute this 2 across this polynomial. I'll get 16x squared plus 52x. 2 times negative 7 is negative 14. 16x squared plus 52x minus 14. Going back to the original, I had 16x squared plus 52x minus 14. So this is going to be the factored answer. Okay? Please make sure you do plenty of these. They're going to show up on tests, and they can be pretty time-consuming. The last thing you want to do is get confused because you've forgotten about how to do them. Okay? So that's going to be it. Good luck. I'll see you next time.